just like that, Obi puts it in. 1, 2, 3, he makes it quick and easy.
Fantastic goal, really it was.
There's the slide through, oh, he's got a man through a goal here. It's a stunning goal from Obi.
What's going on, everyone? My name is Ovi and welcome to a new FIFA 20 video on the channel, guys. In the next couple of minutes, we're gonna talk about the best custom tactics for attack, for defense, for balanced play. Remember, these custom tactics apply to all formations in the game depending on the game plan. We've got, guys, 5 game plans. You've got the balanced, you've got the ultra defensive, defensive attacking and ultra attacking. Before getting started, make sure to smash the like button if you're enjoying the series on the channel. In the moment we hit 2000 likes, guys, I'm gonna upload together with Mike our first episode from the formation reviews. As you know from previous FIFA versions, he does the formation reviews, I do the best custom tactics and player instructions for that particular formation. Getting back to our video, guys. I was telling you that these custom tactics apply to all formations in the game depending the game plans. Let me explain you that a bit more in depth. For example, you are playing, as you are seeing on the screen now, the 4-3-3 fourth variation. This formation with certain custom tactics can also be used as an ultra defensive formation. It's not recommended because you have 2 CMs and not 2 CDMs in this formation, but it can be used. The same is for a 4-1-2-1-2 narrow, 4-4-2, 4-2-3-1, 4-3-2-1. 4-1-2-1-2 wide. All of these formations with certain custom tactics options, they can be used in ultra defensive game plan, in defensive game plan, in attacking game plan, in ultra attacking game plan. So you can have a formation that can be used in all game plans but with the following custom tactics. I have the 4-3-3-4 here only as an example. As I told you before, this works for all formations. Let's start with balanced, guys. And balanced is the name of this game plan. Balanced we will have almost everywhere on the pitch. If you're new to the game, if you don't know what these options mean, guys, let me just get you through them. Pressure on heavy touch means that when you are defending, your players will press for a few seconds when the opponent has a heavy touch. After he receives the ball, if his player has a heavy touch, your players will press automatically for a few seconds. Press after possession loss, you will press your opponent for approximately 7 seconds after you lose possession of the ball. Constant pressure means constant pressure. You pressure the opponent all the time, everywhere on the pitch. This is difficult because your player's stamina will not last. Drop back here, it's a bit more complicated for balanced. If you are a very defensive player, you could do this, but not at balance, guys. I don't advise you that. Dropback means that your defender line will be moving a lot in the back, very close to your goal line. Okay, we've got balance here as a standard option in balance. This is why I recommend you to use. Team width should be on 5, 6 max in defense. 5 is optimum. Team depth, you know, this year players are very fast. I mean, if they get past your defender line, then you're done, you're roasted, you cannot do anything about it anymore, you cannot catch them. This is why depth, even in balanced, should be 3-4-4 most likely is the best option, because you don't want to risk the opponent's strikers getting behind your defender line very easy. Offensive style. Let me just explain everything here and for the new people in FIFA. We've got balanced, which is balanced, is a mixture of all the options in attack. You got long ball. Long ball means that your players will make runs for long balls into space behind the opposing backline or up to a target man. Strikers who are fast with a good attacking positioning attribute are the best at this tactic. This is the long ball. Now, fast build-up. This tactic pushes players forward for a faster build-up. Guys, here, everyone on the pitch, except the center back, let's say if you have the player, the ball at that player, everyone else will be running in attack. It's a very risky formation. I wouldn't use it at balanced, at the balanced game plan. Offensive style, possession. This is too slow, in my opinion. You get a lot of support in passes, but it is extremely difficult sometimes, or it takes too long to launch an attack and get in the opponent's last third of the pitch. This is why I use balanced over here. Team width in attack, I'm gonna have it on 6. I wanna have a more wider formation to be able to open up the defenders. Defense players in the box on 5, corner kicks and free kicks on 3. This was the balanced one. So this is the formation that you use. These are the custom tactics that you use when you start the game, when the score is 0-0, when it's a draw. Now, let's say you've scored, guys, a goal, or maybe 2 goals. It's minutes 50, minutes 60. You want to hold on to the result, but still have options in attack. You're going to move to the defensive game plan. The defensive game plan should have a defensive style balanced. I don't think it's the moment yet for drop back, because it's not the end of the game yet. Team width should be defensively on 5. Team depth here, you could go 3. In this moment, you could go 3 at team depth. Offensive style, still balanced. Team width here, 5. Players in the box, 4. Corner kicks and free kicks on 2. You don't want to risk doing a bad corner kick or a bad free kick and then the opponent scores your counterattack when you are up 1-2 goals. This is the defensive game plan. The ultra defensive game plan, you use it in the last 10 minutes of the game. You want to hold on to a result. You have a 1 goal advantage, a 2 goal advantage. If you have even more, that's even better, but you want to hold on desperately to the advantage. Defensive style, drop back. Team width here, gonna have it on 4. Team depth, 3 or 2. That's personal preference. I have it on 3. You might want to try also the 2. Offensive style, long ball, or I still play here, guys, balanced. I do a lot of player runs manually from L1 on my PlayStation controller or LB on the Xbox One controller. But some of you might want to have this long ball option here so they can launch easier counter attacks. Team width, an attack 5, players in the box 4, corner kicks and free kicks 2 and 2. Moving now to attacking. You are going to use this game plan when the opponent has 1 goal advantage, you want to come back in the game. Maybe he has 2 goal advantage, again you want to come back in the game. You want to put pressure on him, we're going to have the possession of the ball. At defensive style, we're going to have press after possession loss, which means that if you're attacking, each time if you lose the ball, your players will always for a few seconds pressure all the opponents trying to get the ball back. Team width here will be on 5. Team depth, we're gonna increase it a bit and we're gonna jump to 6. Offensive style, I'm keeping it on balanced. Team width, it's gonna be 5 or 6 here. I wanna open up a bit the opponent's defense. Players in the box, we've increased it a bit here also and we have it at 6. Corners and free kicks, you can try 4 or 3. These are the 2 options I'm playing with. Again, it's all up to you, personal preference here, guys. 3 or 4 lines at corner kicks or free kicks. And now for the last one, the ultra offensive option, game plan. You're gonna use this towards the end of the game when you desperately need to come back on the scoreboard. You need a goal, you need 2 goals, you need 3 goals. It doesn't matter sometimes if you lose 2-0 or 4-0. What matters is if you have the chance and if you can come back in that game. You can do it with the ultra offensive option. I use here in defense constant pressure, which means that my players will always be putting pressure on the opponent's players. Yeah, you might say, but their stamina will run off. Guys, you are towards the end of the game. Doesn't really matter. Your stamina soon won't matter because the game finishes. You gotta get that ball back. You gotta put pressure on the opponent. You gotta create chances that you can't create chances if you don't have the ball. Team width here, I have it on 5. Depth, I have it on 7 or 8. Again, play with this. It's one line difference, but play with it, see which is best for you. Offensive style, fast build up. I don't have time to play around now. To build up my attack, I need all my players going in front. I need to have options there. I need faster goal. This is why offensive style is with fast build-up. Team with in attack, we've got it on 6. Players in the box, 7. We want to push for those cut inside options from the wing, the low driven crosses, the crosses for the empty space for the free teammate. Corner kicks and free kicks. Guys, remember, here you are all in. You need these. You need them to, you need everyone to go in front and speculate a chance at a corner kick or at a free kick. So guys, these were my game plans, my 5 game plans that can apply to each formation in the game, depending in which game plan you wanna use that certain formation. Don't forget to smash the like button. In the moment we hit 2000 likes, me and Mike will start again the series in which he does the best formations review and I do the best custom tactics and player instructions for those formations. Thank you all for watching. My name is Ovi and I'll see you guys later.